Welcome. And in this section of the US Signal OpenCloud walkthrough, what we're going to go through is accounts. Now, accounts are very important because it dictates what sort of access a particular user may have within the OpenCloud environment. So let me go down and click on the accounts section. So as you can see, by default, we start off with one account. So in my case, you can see I've got a cloud domain admin account. This allows for me to be able to create the other users that are necessary for this environment to operate. So as you can see, I can click on and select the individual account, and some options over here do become available to me. I can select to enable the account. I can disable the account. I can lock the account. And I can delete the account. Notice that the delete account is grayed out, mostly now due to the fact that I'm using that account in question, but also the delete account operation is very destructive. If there are devices in the compute section that are created from that particular user, when you delete them, you delete those resources as well. So be very careful in deleting accounts, as they may be tied to resources that you may not necessarily know or are able to recover in the event that you end up accidentally deleting a account and getting those resources deleted. So what we're going to do is we're going to add an account. Now, in this case, there are a few predefined roles. You can see we've got cloud support. This basically enables somebody to have the support functionality. They can start and stop instances. They can start snapshot operations, things like that that are under the compute component without basically being able to delete accounts. A cloud admin has all the functionality. This allows them to create domains, create users, create resources, and also in consequence, delete all of those particular resources at the same time. And read-only, well, it's as defined. Somebody who would have only read-only access. They would not be able to perform operations, but they would be able to see what is going on in the environment at that particular time. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create another cloud admin. We're going to use my username, but with the number one behind it. Enter in our password. An email for that particular username. I'm going to use basically a fake email address, as I'm not going to follow through with this and send an email related to it. Now, if I had subdomains, I could associate those subdomains within. But in this particular case, since I only have my root domain, I'm going to use that. Now, the name of the account to be created basically will, as stated, name of the account to be created. This user will be added to the newly created account. If no account is specified, the username will be used as the account name. So, if you want to change the name for some particular reason so that it's not just the straight username, you can enter something here and it'll associate it with that particular account. Now, time zone, I'm going to search for US Central as I'm currently in the Central time zone. And network domain, I don't have anything listed under here for the accounts and networks, so it's going to continue to use the existing ones that are out there. Now, if I go and I click on OK, it's going to create this particular account. But like I said, I'm not going to because I have an email address that I do not want email to be sent to. So I'm going to cancel this. So as we walk through all the different account options, again, we have the ability to enable that particular account, disable the account, lock the account, and delete the account. So if I was able to click on enable account, this would at least enable that account to be able to be used. That would be a login that someone could actually use at that particular case. If I disabled the account, that user would not be able to log in. That account would not necessarily be deleted, but they wouldn't be able to log in. Locking the account ensures that that account cannot be used in any fashion. So you can see we're getting progressively more and more restrictive as we go along. And finally, the delete account. As I mentioned, this is very destructive. Delete, ensuring you know exactly what that user had available to them in the environment, or you will delete those particular resources. So this has been a walkthrough of the OpenCloud account section. If you need any more information, feel free to refer to the US Signal docs related to this product, and we look forward to you to watching the next video. Thanks.